Physicist Ronald Mickens explains how black Manhattan Project scientists like J. Ernest Wilkins dealt with discrimination.
Their way to resolve issues involving race was to perform at a very high level. You know, and so they were very careful. They had dress codes. Except for a few photos that I have of him, almost always when you see Wilkins, he had a shirt and tie on. You had to be able to speak well. And if you're a scientist or a mathematician, you had to be top. You had to be a top person. You just couldn't go out and say anything you wanted, you know, because it was not so much that you were representing the race, you were representing yourself, and you had high standards. You have to understand that for people of his status, and I'm talking about within the context of the black community, you did not complain. What you did is if you had issues, you resolved them. They may not be resolved to your satisfaction, but you resolved them. You see now why a lot of people like J. Ernest and people of his generation, they were very proudly black, even though they didn't have to do that, you know, because they felt as if it is demeaning to deny my ancestors. And so they strove to do the best that they could to outperform people.
Dr. Percy Julian overcame a lifetime of discrimination to become one of America's leading scientists. Born in 1899, the grandson of enslaved people, he grew up in Montgomery, Alabama, but was barred from the segregated high school. Nonetheless, he received a Ph.D. in chemistry and was very successful as an entrepreneur. In 1950, he and his family became the first African Americans to move into the exclusive Chicago suburb of Oak Park. But before they could even move in, their house was firebombed and later attacked with dynamite. Hundreds of Oak Park citizens were appalled and urged them to stay, but the threats continued. Ronald Mickens shares his amazement at Julian's determination.
My interest has always been how, within the context of one's individual environment, how do you decide that you want to be creative? How do you decide that you're going to perform at a very high level and still deal with these other problems? How did someone like a Percy Julian function who was operating at the highest levels of research and development in organic chemistry and yet had to worry about whether somebody was going to blow up his house or set his house on fire or shoot him?
At the same time he battled discrimination, Dr. Julian made important discoveries dealing with synthetic hormones, steroids, and other drugs. He became the second African American to be inducted into the National Academy of Sciences.